Okay, try to answer some questions, some comments. Today I came early. Yeah, I came half hour earlier. So what? Okay. To be able to answer a couple of comments. Again, my accent is not the best, guys. I'm trying my best. So, let's start from the latest comments. There is one friend here says, fuel injector getting stuck is what they were most likely getting at. Cause a massive rich condition, blown motor. This comment placed on the C63 with 80,000 kilometers checkup. This I answer to you also that I have hit that before. I never faced these issues here. The last 6 years, I never saw that here in UAE. Maybe it's the petrol, maybe I don't have a clue what. On the specific C63, since it doesn't have gasoline converters, the first thing is turn off the secondary oxygen sensors. It's not important to turn off the air injection pump, but at the same time, since you don't have gasoline converters, why you don't turn it off? So first, I want from the tuning to turn off the secondary oxygen sensors to don't read, and then to see the values, to see the fuel pressure, if I have fuel pressure drop or something else or whatever. Or see, even let us say, to put the lambda sensor and see the each bank what's going on. The customer, he was having a problem with the cold start. When he was starting the car in the morning, it will start making stupid things. Actually, I saw it also. I saw the same thing when I start the car. Today I have to go to start it again to see if it's happening again the same thing. So, then, let me pause it to see what other comments are here. Another one comment. Have you thought about getting a GoPro with a headband strap? That wouldn't be too bad. That wouldn't be too bad. Thanks. They have said to me that too many people the same thing, to put a GoPro and put on my head. The funny thing is, I have one light, actually. But sometimes when something is difficult, I have this light for the head and I'm putting it. What's the problem with this one? I'm always hitting on the car down, and this is not so high. I always have some problems. Second thing, the videos is, as I mentioned earlier, before, some people, they're new subscribers, they came now to the channel, let us say. They don't know that these videos, it's for the customers. Now, if you can get some information from the videos, it's good, you know. But this is purely for the customers, to see what it takes and what I saw. That means, except of the job card, except, let us say, that what I write on the paper, to see physically through the video what's going on in their cars. You want to have a general idea what's going on. Then, I mentioned also earlier in the previous videos, I've said that a couple of times, I'm not a YouTuber. That's why you see, I mean, if you see the most of the videos, I'm shaking, I'm moving fast the camera, it's out of focus. I make mistakes while I'm talking. And again, when I have the camera, let's say I'm checking one car, when I close the camera, I have to check again because I have to write it down properly. Not in general, like what you see on the camera. In the camera, let's say, you see in general what I see that time. Then when I leave the camera down, I'm getting the Joker with me, and I'm taking one by one to be 100% correct. And again, you want to like the video, you want to dislike the video, you want to unsubscribe or subscribe, it's purely up to you. I'm not making money from YouTube, I'm not a YouTuber, it's not my job, you know, I'm just posting the videos on YouTube. Instead of having, let us say, on external hard disk drive, and have, let us say, 10 hard disk drives in my house, I'm just uploading YouTube, I'm deleting from everywhere else, and I have it over there all together. That's the point. Now, there are also some friends that I have met through from YouTube. They're very good guys. We also have some conversations. I'm really happy that I have these guys. That we share the knowledge, or even they're asking a couple of questions from their problems. You know, it's like experience. You're collecting data. Let's continue. I'm going to try to answer as many as possible. Let's see. There is also this comment from Max Off, I think. As I mentioned, I replied to you. I wrote for you down. That's not a mistake from the camera. It's my mistake. I didn't bought the proper camera, the right camera, back that time. You are right. You are absolutely right. And you have all the rights, you know, to dislike or to unsubscribe or to do whatever you want. It's right. Yes. It's even me when I'm watching some videos and it's out of focus. I'm saying, okay, let's go. It's gonna come on focus, and then at the end it's not going on focus and it's pissing you off even more. Will 2013 C63 MZ will fit on the 2007 W211 E63? Yes, I answer already that. Then there is also another guy here. He's asking what kind of engine oil I'm using. And there is also another guy down, says olive oil if you are Greek. In some cases, you know what? Now that I'm thinking, the olive oil is going to work much better than the 0W40, what they're suggesting in some countries. You have better chances to not lose the camshafts. Let me continue to read. So, is a car with M272 engine with 200,000 kilometers good to buy? It depends the maintenance. It depends, let's say, how often you change the engine oil. It depends how you are driving the car. I mean, you cannot say that this engine, let's say any engine, you cannot say that this engine is gonna last for 200,000 kilometers or for 500,000 kilometers. You see the average. You see, let's say that these engines, they can make, let's say, example, between 200 and 300,000 kilometers. Then there can be the problems. But there are some cases. I have some friends that they are mechanics, most of them, of my friends. So what's happening? When you change the oil more often and you take care about the car, the coolant, you are pushing when the temperatures are properly to push. What I mean by that, for example, you are 50 degrees on summer with air conditioning on and there are four people inside the car. You're not gonna start pushing the car at noon with four people inside with air conditioning on, that all the temperatures are on the limit. Or let us say you are pushing the car for 400 meters, then you hit the brake and then you start pushing again. This is wrong. Let's say you push for 400 meters, then you are cruising normal without load the engine to have enough airflow to cool all the coolers down, oil cooler, coolant, everything, to go back in normal, and then you push again. It depends the setup, it depends the boost. But this is to keep it long time, the engine. Keep in mind that any engine, let us say, especially modified engine, tuned engine, just pushed continuously, let us say, four times 400 meters, continuously. Let us say, push once, stop, push again, stop, push again. At the end, you're going to have high integral temperature, you're going to have a high oil temperature. And if, let us say, there is no fail safe, you're going to melt the piston, you're going to lose the engine at the end. To break something is very easy. To prevent from breaking and keeping it, let us say, for a long time, that's a little bit more hard. Not hard, actually, it's the attitude, how you are driving, how you are using the car, and the maintenance. Then, another comment here. Can you add tags in your videos? Trust me, man, I have a hard time to find my own videos. I don't even remember. I don't know even how to find it. But it's again the same story, except that I don't know how to trim, how to edit the videos. The only thing what I'm doing, let us say, because the camera, it can record 20 minutes. And let us say now I'm clicking the pause, and then I'm not pausing actually. This is different clips. So what I'm doing? I'm putting all the videos together. That's it. I'm not editing nothing. I don't have the time to do it. I prefer to spend, let's say, 5-6 minutes with my son, with my family when I go back to home. That again, when I go back at night, my son is sleeping, so I don't even have the chance to see him. Then let's continue. Go to the next one. I don't want to say on which video is this comment, but don't be mean, man. I mean, this is obviously, see, what happened there. I don't know if you're watching the video, I hope that you're watching the video. what's happening there? The owner, he told me that he never touched the engine and he was going always to the engine seat. Okay? From my side, when I was opening the engine, I didn't saw if somebody open and close the engine, he will gonna be professional. I mean, I didn't saw extra sealant or something like that. It was very surprised for me to see the crankshaft bolts, the crankshaft cap bolts. It was so much stretched. Actually, it was breaking. I couldn't even lose it. It came out when I opened the lower case. So now, either I have to say that the customer is a liar, because you see on the video that the crankshaft main bearings are upside down. The upper, that they have the oil gallery that's passing the oil pressure, it was down and the down was up. It was blocked. It cannot work like that. You can only let us say the engine like that for how much? Maximum 500 kilometers. After that, you're gonna melt everything. It does have a physically, it does have a path to pass the oil to lubricate the crankshaft, not even 500 kilometers. Maybe I'm saying too much. So, either I have to say that the customer is a liar, or I have to say that the agency or the factory, they make a mistake. So, I don't want to go against anybody. And I post the video as it is. Even I was saying, I was having a clip that I didn't post that clip. I said that either the customer or from the factory, but most probably the customer, he did say to me all the truth. There is no problem. It's fine. It's fine with me. I have dealt with some people that they're not saying the truth. I don't know why. I'm not gonna judge them. You know, I never say to anybody, you know, what you did or why you did. I can say to you my opinion. I'm giving my opinion. So, and another one thing. Nobody belongs to anybody. What does mean that one? The guys that say that they're working here, they're free to go wherever they want. From my side, I'm showing to them everything. Maybe they'll say they can find a better job with better salary. Maybe they can go to open their own garage. It's fine. It's not belong to me. It's not my employees or something. We are all together. We are working together. The same thing with the customers. There is no customer that to say that, this is my customer. It's not belong to you, the customer. It's up to the customer if you want to continue to come into one garage. Or let's say there are some people, for example, they have one garage for normal maintenance and another one garage that, you know what, they're going to go there to modify some things. Or like how you're going, let's say, to a tire shop to make the wheel alignment, to fix the tires, balancing, all this kind of stuff. Same thing for maintenance, same thing for big stuff. It depends. But you cannot say that, you know what, this is my customer. It's not right. I don't feel like that, you know, it's very, for me, it's very selfish to do such a thing, or to push somebody. Yeah, tell me about it. Okay, let's see now. Yeah, that's it, guys. That's it, because now there are too many comments, actually. I don't know too. This is a general. That's a general. You know, a couple of comments that I choose now, the latest comments. Now, wait, there's another one. Yes. The camshafts. If you change this, use OM or better upgraded camshafts. Greeting from Germany. Yeah. This is all about the customer. If the customer, he wants to put, let us say, the original camshafts, or he wants to put upgrade camshafts. It's his choice, his option. Just, we have two types of upgrade camshafts. There is camshafts to avoid to have the wear, and there are camshafts also that has different profile for performance. It depends. In one case, for example, on the performance camshafts, I'm gonna show you now, 1 second, now what I mean. The performance camshafts. Come on. Do you see with the stupid focus now I have to click? Alright. On the performance camshafts, because they are missing some materials from there. Well, yeah, that's just now. Throw it down.
That's the old one.
So I have to change this from the lifter. This is the distance that's stepping, this stepping on the valve, intake or exhaust. And this is how much the distance. So if you remove material from the camshaft, you have to put these materials here on the lifter so the lifter to work properly, to don't be uncompressed, because you're gonna reach in one point that you're not gonna have tension, the lifter not gonna work. And this is, these are the these are all these things. In this case, what you have to do, you have to break all 32 pocket valves or hydraulic lifters, remove this from inside, choose the correct one to have the clearance, the correct clearance between the lobe and the valve. And yeah, this is a drop in the ocean, but it's okay, let's, since I saw that, we have also this. This is the safe to secure it inside. Put a new one time. I didn't mention also another one thing before. Let's make it here. Let's do it here. The camshafts. I need to bring also the hydraulic lifter. One second. If you see the camshafts that they're running on this style of lifter, the lobes of the camshafts, they're not straight. They're never straight. You can only see by eye. You can count it. There are some degrees different. Why it's happening that? Because if it was straight, exactly straight, perfect straight, it'll gonna run always in one spot on the lobe. Always here. But because they are slightly off, what they're doing, they're turning the pocket valve. That means, that's why you see that it has equal wear everywhere. And when it's destroying that curve, that means when on the lobe it has a wear and then it's coming flat, you can see that start eating the hydraulic lift of the pocket valve in one spot only. That's why you see these round marks. You can see, you don't see, let us say, one mark in the center. You see that it was turning. If you are able, let us say, to start the engine without the cover, and you see, you're gonna see that the lifter is gonna make like this movement while it's working the camshaft. Each time that's passing the lobe through the pocket, it's turning. That's it. So yes, finish. Thank you very much. Let's start working. It's happening all the time. I'm finishing the video and then I'm remembering another one thing. Actually, it's in front of me and I'm saying, okay, you know what, since I mentioned for the camshafts and this kind of stuff, let me finish it. Some people, they're asking why it's making the sound, let's say, on the startup, the camshaft adjuster. And start making continuously, for example. This is happening for one simple reason. If you see on the solenoids here, from where it's passing the oil, there are two paths inside. There is, it's one here and one here. If you see here, there is here the rings that it's sealing, so don't escape the oil, and it's coming oil pressure here, it's coming oil pressure here. One of this hole, it's ending up here around, and the other hole, it's ending up inside over there. Yeah, you cannot see now, I need to bring the light. Okay, if you see, it's... yeah, you can see over there. Here is the bolt that's sealing, and here, one, it's sealed on the camshaft adjuster, and the other one in the center of the camshaft adjuster. If you come here on the camshaft adjuster, the outer, it seals here outer, the inner, it sits here in the center. So these holes, it's communicated with these holes, and then the inner, it goes to these holes. There, inside. So what's happening? When you start the car, it's giving oil pressure to go to the zero position to start the car. So this is what it take. Okay. So this going on the locking position, where it's supposed to be when it's locked, let us say the camshaft. When you start the car, it does have oil pressure. That's why it starts rattling inside. When it's building up pressure, it's going to the zero position. Then, when it's actually activating the solenoid valves and it's opening the path, it's giving the advance on the camshaft. And then it's returning back again, it's closing it. That means it doesn't depend only on this small barrel with a spring. This is just only for the startup when you start it, and to have some extra pressure over there. I mean, with a combination with the oil pressure. That's why when you start a car, you hear the clacking sound from inside, the sound that's making the camshaft adjuster, and then pop, it stops. The point is, when it's gonna collapse, because when every cold startup, let's say every time that you're gonna start the car, it starts hitting everywhere, the camshaft adjuster, you don't know when it's gonna come apart inside. So, yeah, that's it. Now this is the end. Thank you very much.